Oh yeah. Oh. Oh yeah. Yeah, that's what I'm wanting.
You got him.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
This episode of the ITM Fishing Show, New Zealand's most awarded and celebrated fishing show, is made available for you to watch right here for free, thanks to our mates at ITM. Good buggers, eh?
This week we're continuing on our land-based fishing expedition with six lucky winners that have been split into two groups and choppered to two separate locations in the Bay of Islands. One group is fishing with Justin at Mystery Rock, and I've got three guys with me at Mystery Island.
Here he comes, here he comes, he's got it, yes!
Oh, that's, no,
oh, look what he has done!
That snapper just came up and grabbed your bait off the surface, and what did you do? Pulled your live rod straight away.
So far, I've been busy showing these guys the basics of land-based snapper fishing, and there are plenty of snapper right here at our feet to practice on. I'm so busy helping the other guys and feeding these snapper that I haven't even had a chance to throw a bait in the water.
Now you can see that's a chunk of our burley there. I've just watched the big snapper come in through the burley pot, grab a hold of the bag, and there he is, he's on it again. Look at him, he's a nice one. He's just torn that burley bag open to get that burley out. They are so turned on by all that smell and taste. I mean, you and I know what it's like when you can smell something and you really want to eat it and you can't get to it. And this snapper here, I've put him over 10 pounds, has just torn our burley bag apart. And his mate has got to be 8 or 9 pounds. Oh, look, 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 right there, right there. He's grabbing a hold of the burley pot and he is rattling it against the rocks. Now, I don't want to pull that out of the water, but I also don't want to run out of burley. Just going to fill this up for your mates. This, they're like my little pets. The snapper here at Mystery Island is amazing. And look at that, they're patiently waiting for me to drop the burley bag back in, the next burley bag, so they can tear it apart again. There it is, mate. Here you go, there's your burley. There's some nice solid ones there. Now, of course, I've been too into getting this footage to show you because this is something special that I haven't actually hooked a fish. And I mean, these guys are catching plenty for all of us. But I am going to put a bait out with no hook in it on my little camera. Now, if I can just hold that down there and I'll make sure I've got a good grip so they don't rip it out of my hand. See if they'll eat that hook. Keep an eye on that, here he comes. Here comes the snapper. Oh, did you see me right here?
While the guys are hauling in snapper here at Mystery Island, let's see how they're getting on over at Mystery Rock.
He's an awesome fish. Best of the day.
Like I said, that burley started working, fresh baits, oh, nothing better.
He's off.
Oh man, fishing on the rocks, helicopter ride. Insane.
Here you are.
I finally succumbed to the urge to put a bait on, and what I've gone for here is just a fresh slab of one of the kahawai the guys caught earlier on, and I've taken the skin off of it because when it's fresh like this, it's a nice firm bait, and hopefully that'll entice one of those snappity. Oh, well, not the ideal start. He got me bait. Okay. Kawai slab take two. Something's picked it up.
Oh,
What do you know? It's one of our bros.
Look at that, eh?
Sitting right down there, mate. Nice fish. They're all nice fish, aren't they, boys?
Yeah.
That's just a stunning kelp fish. Good size, the size we like to eat. Any much bigger than that and I'd be putting it back. I've got my same piece of kahawai back out of that snapper and I'll demonstrate the casting technique required for here.
That's it.
Let me pick my bait up. Oh, came tight and then pulled the hook out. Bugger. Felt like a heavy fish too.
Talk us through it, bro. You got your own fishing show now.
Okay, what happened here, folks? I've just put on a kahawai, like Matt said, with no skin on it. And let me tell you, I think I've got the big one here, folks.
Beautiful, mate. Beautiful. My protege. Oh, keep him moving, mate. Don't let him go to ground. Keep him moving. Nice one. There he is. I see him. You're all right now. You got him over that kelp. Something's picked me bait up.
So, do that and see what happens, eh? Ooh, oh, ooh, there was a bit of weight there in the end.
Not a bad size, ain't it? Now, when you're working around the snapper's mouth, folks, you want to be very careful because those teeth are very sharp. See that? There we go, folks.
The big bait, like a kahawai head, has caught us many 20 pounders. Picked it up. There we go, mate.
Well, I hope you're enjoying this classic episode, but if you'd like to see our latest content, action, tips, and how-to videos, you can get it all on the Ultimate Fishing app, available now at the App Store, Google Play, or by visiting ultimatefishing.tv.
Got a duck. There's a snapper down there, and he is dark as, kelpy as. Hardly see him. You see how they bleed into the kelp? There's one on my line too. Peck-pecking. But it's that peck-pecking from those little fish that can attract the attention of the bigger guys. Whoa! Speaking of the devil. Yay! Oh, it's a nice one, boy! That'll be the fish of the day if you get him. Now go down and claim him for your own. Good man, mate. Good man.
And that's what I'm talking about, fishing with Matt, folks.
There's no prizes for guessing why that fella's got such a fat belly. He's been swimming around and eating this stuff all morning. Away he goes. Mate, this rules the world. You can see them coming through. This water's so crystal clear here at Mystery Rock. He's gonna survive, and why shouldn't he? Soon as he's given me such great enjoyment. Theirs is hooked up, literally right under the rock here, dropping it straight down, and of course, what do you know, it's a snapper. Winched it in. Dominated it with the bait runner.
Oh, sweet.
Good on you, fellas. Nice one. Oh, see him go to ground there, yeah. Going for that kelp. It's wicked you when you can actually see what's going on. Oh, there's a big one following up. See his mate? There was one about twice as big followed him. Just bring him around here. Keep his head up. He's a fish cage, and just wait for a wave. See, the wave's gone back, don't worry, we're all right. Wait for the wave to wash him up, and then get him behind him. Wave goes back, and we've got our snapper. What's the biggest snapper you've caught?
Not as big as that.
Not as big as this? Well, you got a new personal best. That's a nice one there, buddy. The one that I saw fire with this guy in was twice the size. So, what do you want to do, mate? You want to keep him, or? Okay, mate. It's your call.
Yeah.
Remember, guys, we're just probably 3 hours into 3 days of fishing, so just got to think about how much fish we're going to be taking.
Yep.
Well done, bro.
It's
enough though, eh? Okay, we'll give him the 10, eh?
Yeah, I'm onto it now, my mate.
You boys are unstoppable. We've got a mighty sack of fish here. I wonder how those other boys are getting on.
Yeah.
Mm. Be interesting to see whether it's your guys' skill, the spot, or whether they're just everywhere here. Mind you, they have got Justin with them, so.
Justin's onto it?
Yeah. Let's say for a fisherman, Justin's a great comedian.
Don't be scared of putting big baits out. What I'm doing here is walking the bait. Now the reason being today is we've got an extremely strong wind that's blowing in, and what it's doing, it's blowing big bellies in our line. So what I'm doing is I'm just walking the bait so it keeps all the slack out of it and keeps us in touch with our big baits. Oh yeah! Oh! 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 Oh yeah! Well, that was just that big bait that I put out, and it has just been monstered, and this guy is heading straight up. This type of fish, but that's why we use good quality mono, 60, 80 pound Suffolk straights, and that's why we land fish like this. Number two, yes! I don't want to go home now, but I do want to go into that helicopter again. That was that big bait that I showed you, and he just monstered it. Okay, well he's a nice sort of 15 odd pound fish, but once again we're going to let him go because he's a good breeding size. Well, I don't know how the other boys are going, but I can't see how it's getting much better than this. Haven't quite got our 20, but pretty close.
Well, time and time again, you've seen it on the show, particularly fishing in areas like this, gnarly country, the big bait, like a kahawai head, has caught us many 20 pounders. So I see no reason why I shouldn't do it again today.
Big bait's been picked up and it's run to ground because I was rescuing your kahawai, bro. Look, geez, I know you want to be the star of the show and all, but sabotage, bro, it's not on. Fair's fair, eh? Bugger. Oh. It burns!
Take your time, mate, take your time. See, you got him off the bottom, mate. Take your time. Enjoy it. Okay. Your gutter over there, use your gutter, use your gutter. We only have to worry if it was a big one.
Oh, scatter it up,
baby. There you go, bro.
Yeah.
That's a nice one. They all seem to be this sort of nice size. I'll tell you what we'll do, mate. We'll see where he's hooked. Hold him nice and firm, be firm with him. Just like your kid. Be firm but kind. Except if you're going to eat it, that's it. Give him a warm embrace. Okay, we'll just have a look where he's hooked. He's in the corner of the mouth. Well, you've got him, you keep that firm grip. Okay, pop that hook. Now I'll hold that rod.
Yeah.
And you go put it back.
Okay.
We got enough, bro.
Okay.
Good man.
Oh. Go, mate.
Look at him go. Look at him. Coming away down there, beautiful. Feels good, doesn't it, mate?
Yeah.
Feels good.
Oh, that was me.
Big bait, that's my big bait. Keep going, boy. You still got it. It's a whole fillet of kahawai. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Please be there. Oh! Bastard!
Bye. Blasted or busted?
No, I said busted. Busted. Just, I gave that, because that was a whole fillet of kahawai, I gave the snapper plenty of time, but it's a catch 22. Give him plenty of time to eat the big fillet, but of course a big fish doesn't take him long to eat it, and then all I'm doing is giving him a head start into the kelp, and when I tightened up then, line came tight, on the rocks, ping.
Well, what Matt was saying, that you got to check your line sometimes, because if it's got twists and tangles, easily to break in the water, apparently.
Yep. So
that's fishing all about, folks.
Fishing with Alex. Beautiful, bro. Beautiful. Oh, yeah, mate. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Here we go. A bit more like it, boys.
Yeah, yo.
It's not a real big one. Not a small one, though, either. I mean, it's not half the size of a couple of those real good whacks that I've had on those big fillets. But all the same, I think we're getting a little bit spoiled. I don't want to sound like I'm getting desensitized to the awesomeness of catching snapper off the rocks. It's just that we've caught so many this morning. This one's not a bad one by the look of them. Mate, there's just been so many nice solid fish like this.
Ooh, that's a biggie.
Biggie? Nah, bro. It's just warming up, bro. Okay, I'll just wait for that next swell. And look at that, away he goes. There we go, bro. No quarter given. Moving. Snapper! That's all good, bro. You alright, mate? Just waiting for my swell. I'll wash it off into this gut. Look at that. Thank you. Can you hold that for us, please, bud? Hey. These are just solid, respectable fish. Middle of winter, far north. Oh, mystery part of New Zealand. He's gonna go back to the reef where he can do his thing.
There goes the swell, there goes the fish.
Back from whence he came. Well, I guess you could say our expedition's got off to a pretty good start, really. I mean, the boys over there, Bob, Des, and Alex, they've all caught personal best snappers. Of course, we've still got to catch up with the other guys. I mean, I'm sure they're having an equally as good day just a few miles down the coast.
Well, like all good things, everything has to come to an end, and our first day of three ways in 3 days is drawing to an end. As you can see, we've got Kingsley here from Heliops is coming to pick us up after 8 hours on the rocks. And what do you reckon, guys? Had a good day?
Awesome,
bro. Oh yeah. So and to the last second, the guys are still catching fish, but everyone's thirsty and keen for a cheeky lion red. So we'll see you back there.
Whoa!
We got a goodie. Well, last bait. Helicopter has just flown over, and I mean, I couldn't help put one more bait out. And so far, it looks like it's done the trick again. As you can see, the burley pot is dead empty, so that has definitely done its job for us today.
Done the job, are you all right?
Get him in there! Yeah! Woo! Oh, another fatty. He's obviously been eating all the bait and burley you boys have been putting in there today. Because he's fatty. What a day. And I've still got a helicopter ride to look forward to. So, yes.
Awesome!
One more thing for the day. This beautiful fish is going back. Thank you for the fun. Yes. Woo! Right, Kingsley, take us home.
These bait runners, real simple to use. Open the bail, I'm over, and it's just a little underarm lob. This lever on the bottom, that's your bait runner, which means that the line can run out freely. Cummings picked it up. You'll let it run out just for a couple of seconds. As soon as you turn the handle, it engages the gears. And that's how the system works in full effect.
We hope you enjoyed this classic episode. But if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.